seen lots of different toys claim to do lots and lots of different things, but this is the first toy I've seen that claims to defy gravity. It's the Hexbots Gecko Wall Climber. And as the name suggests, it's supposed to crawl on walls, which I'm gonna be honest, I'm pretty skeptical about. So I'm super excited to just open it up and see how it works. Aha, wow. That's a lot of French. Let's just put these over here for now. Come here, Gecko.
Over here.
Aha. Cool. Super light. Whoa. Okay. It's very, very loud. Wow. Oh! Let's see. Oh my gosh! What? Ah, come back! Oh wait, wait, turn around, turn around. Come back, that's super fast! That is awesome! I was not expecting it to A, stick that well, and B, move so fast. That's a very speedy little thing. Let's, I guess, try and work out exactly what it does. So I'll pop it back on the wall. Yeah, we're now forwards, backwards. No. It does really tight turns, which is awesome. Wow. Okay. Oh, you could cause so much chaos with this thing. What I'm really interested in is to see whether it can go upside down. So let's try that out. So we've replaced our tabletop with some Perspex, which is a little bit see-through. So we can test out whether it goes upside down. Oh wow, it still sticks when it's upside down. Oh, this is so cool. Well, it's stuck for a while. It's not a completely flat surface, which I think this needs, but it does go upside down, which means it's lightweight enough to defy gravity. It does exactly what it says on the box, which makes it a super cool toy. But let's find out how it actually sticks. So to do that, we're gonna have to tear it down. Gonna need a screwdriver. All right, let's see what's inside. Ah, okay. I've got to remove the head now. Sorry, mate. Tail. That's all right, the tail will grow back. Cool. Whoops. Awesome. So we're inside, and I can see there's a lot going on with this toy. So there's two motors, one here and one here. Those are powering the wheels. What they're also powering is the little leg movements. So they're attached to a cam here and a linkage, which basically just turns the rotation of the motor into a linear motion, which kind of makes it look like it's scuttling around. And if I turn it on, we can see that a little bit closer. Awesome, okay. The main thing though is how this actually sticks to the wall, and I think it's got something to do with this part here, so I'm gonna pull that off and have a look. All right, so we're in, and revealing probably the tiniest battery I've ever seen in my life, which is super cute. The battery's powering the two motors that move the wheels as well as the cams and arms and legs, but it's also powering this thing, which is super important. Looks exactly like a fan, and that's because it is a fan. What that fan's doing is as it spins, it's pushing air outwards, and as it does that, it creates a low pressure area behind it, which is underneath the toy. Because it's low pressure underneath, all of the air around it is higher pressure, which pushes it up against the wall, so it keeps it there. But that's not doing all the work. It's also got this little skirt here, which is super duper important. This here is basically creating a seal so that high pressure air outside doesn't come underneath into this low pressure zone, unsticking it from the wall. So it's essentially all about air pressure, which is kind of easily explained using something that you all know and probably don't love, the vacuum cleaner. So how does that work? Well, air always likes to stay in equilibrium, which basically just means equal pressure. So air in high pressure areas tends to like to move to places of lower pressure, like the air in this can. Ooh. Ooh. I feel like someone shook that up. In the case of a vacuum, you've got a fan inside, which blows outward. And in doing so, it's actually creating a low pressure zone inside the vacuum. The air on the outside is of higher pressure and wants to move into that low pressure zone. So the only way in is through the tube. And as it does that, it so happens to suck up a bunch of other things at the same time. That's exactly what's happening inside this toy. This is essentially a vacuum cleaner. But as cool as this toy is, it's all a lie. Real geckos don't use vacuum cleaners or skirts to stick on the wall. They actually use something even cooler, which makes them a super unique and fascinating creature. Geckos are super unique because they don't use sticky pads or suction cups to stick. Instead, they have tiny microscopic nanostructures on their feet. These tiny microscopic nanostructures are called setae. Those millions of hair-like setae then branch out into hundreds more spatulae, which are called spatulae because they look kind of like spatulas. So how do these spatulae allow geckos to stick to stuff? Well, it's thanks to a thing called van der Waals forces, which are weak attractive forces between molecules. And thanks to the sheer amount of these tiny spatulae on the gecko's feet, basically it's creating tons and tons of different molecular attractions between the gecko's feet and the surface that it's on, which means that they can pretty much stick to almost any surface. And because they don't use like a gluey, sticky substance, it also means that they can remove their feet really, really quickly, so they can scuttle very, very fast. So essentially, what our gecko is doing is it's just creating these incredible bonds on a molecular level to the surface that it's on, which is pretty fascinating. So while this toy doesn't use van der Waals forces to stick to things, plenty of other gecko-inspired technology is out there. Things like gecko tape, which might be used to hang up picture frames. There's also amazing nanotape, which is being developed and used in space by people like NASA, as well as in robotics. As much as I dream of gecko-inspired technology that will allow me to climb walls Spider-Man style, unfortunately that tech hasn't quite made it to toys yet. But it might do in the future, and got me thinking about some of the amazing toys that might be just around the corner. This toy is around right now and it's super fun. So I hope you enjoyed this episode of Toy Teardown. Maybe I should do some cleaning with this thing. I don't know. I'd love to know what kinds of toys you would love to see in the future. But until next time. Spatulae.